Yeah, I'm Les Down. I'm one of the charter members of the Speed Lions Club. Before we chartered, actually, we said, well, if we're going to be a Lions Club, we've got to earn some money. And we sort of had a few projects. So this machinery field days come to light. So we thought, well, let's have a go. So the first year we set up a big circle, a bit like a football match, actually, and we had 39 exhibitors. And the next year we moved to another paddock somewhere or other and set up temporary toilets and cook sabs. And we had 69, I think, exhibitors. And this is now we're up to the 35th field days. It's grown to about 360 sites. We keep it static at that. And we used to say years ago, oh, we had $10 million worth of stuff. Now we're finding that we've got about three exhibitors that are all carrying about $5 million worth of equipment on their sites, each one. And it's just a magnificent 2 days that we put in. We utilise neighbouring Lions clubs, football clubs for catering, for manning gates. There's only about 20 of us now. We used to have about 28 in our club, but we're managing quite well. We utilise the district, and the great thing is the money's going back into our district. We earn around about 45,000 a year. We donate to charity in April each year. We give about 25,000 to the set charities that ask for it, but we do donate probably another 10,000 or 15,000 to locals. We've had a few people having cancer treatment, and when you realise that they've got to travel to Melbourne or to Adelaide for these treatments, it costs money. So we often give out $1,000 here and there. We sponsor all our students that go off to university. They get about $1,000 each to help buy their books. We've look after people in need in many ways. So we had a dream back in 79. It's grown more or less beyond what we expected, and we just realised what a wonderful thing it is. And first 7 or 8 years we were nomadic, we travelled paddock to paddock, but it was difficult with toilets and things, so now we've got our set site and we got all the facilities there. And one thing we're contemplating now, we just want to set up a new office, so just let's go. As I said, when we started in 79, we just said, well, we picked a few stumps and sold them. We picked up bottles and crushed them, and we said, this is not on. We've got to get a definite project. You can't run a an organisation or a club or anything without some dream. You've got to set something up. You've got to build flats. You've got to get some good project, and you just got to set your mind to it and be prepared to work for it. And that's what we did, and we're now reaping our rewards.